Okay, the first part of this lesson, revision two, about trigonometry, we talk about sine, cosine, tan of sum and difference of two angles. Okay, sum or difference of two angles. I advise you to write, or of course, I know. You have the worksheet in front of you, but if you don't have the worksheet, please write the rules in front of you. Sine A plus B equals sine A cosine B plus cosine A sine B. Cosine A plus B cosine cosine minus sine sine. Tan A plus B tan A plus tan B over 1 minus tan A tan B. And double angle formulae. Sine 2A, it's just one formula, 2 sine cosine. Cosine 2a cosine squared minus sine squared, or 2 cosine squared minus 1, or 1 minus 2 sine squared. Tan 2a, it's 2 tan a over 1 minus tan squared a. As we did in revision 1, I give you about 2 minutes to solve a question, and then I answer you. Start to solve question number 1. Prove the identity. Okay, now in identity, we start with one side. And we have to work to reach to the other side. It depends on which side we can start. Here, in part I, the complicated side is the left-hand side, cosine x plus 30 and sine x plus 60. So we're starting the solution with the left-hand side. Left-hand side equals cosine A cosine x plus 30. It's a cosine the sum of two angles. So it's a cosine, cosine, sine, sine. Cosine x, cosine 30, plus becomes minus, sine x, sine 30, plus. The second one is sine x plus 60, sine, cosine, cosine, sine. So it is sine x cosine 60 plus sine cosine cosine x sine 60. We change the system to calculator, or you have to check. It must be degree here. So shift mode 3. And then find cosine 30 by using the calculator. Cosine 30 equals the radical 3. Over 2. So this is cosine 30. So cosine 30 equals the radical 3 over 2. Multiply cosine x minus sine 30. Sine 30 is half. Remember, this is sine 30 in front. Sine x. The same here. Cosine 60. Is half multiply sine x plus sine 60 radical 3 over 2 cosine x. Simplify. Negative half sine x cancel with positive half sine x. Radical 3 over 2 cosine plus radical 3 over 2 cosine, it's 2 times radical 3, 2 times radical 3 over 2 cosine x, radical 3 over 2 plus itself, it's 2. Cancel 2 with 2, then the answer is radical 3 cosine x, which is the right hand side. So this is the first part. Second part is said, hence solve the equation. We have to look at what the domain the values of x. It here, it's in between 0 and 90 degrees. Ready? This side here, in the first step, this side here, cosine x plus 30 plus sine x plus 60, its value is radical 3 cosine x. Then in the second part, we say radical 3 cosine x equals 1. We solve this equation to get the value of x. Divide both sides by radical 3. Cosine x equals 1 over radical 3. It's positive value. Okay? So it's a positive value. When cosine be positive, remember this formula. So remember this rule, ASTC. So cosine is positive in the first or fourth, but angle X in the given, it is in the first. Then the answer B in the first quadrant. Because cosine is positive, so X lies in first or fourth quadrant. But because the domain, because x in between 0 and 90, then we say x in first quadrant only, in first quadrant. How can we get x? We go to the calculator and we write arc cosine, shift cosine 1 over radical 3. The value is 54.7 degrees, and this is the answer. Okay, guys? Okay, now, next question. Try to solve this. I give you 2 minutes to solve, and then I solve this. Right. Use your pencil and solve with me to understand the lesson. Ready? Question number 2. It said show that 12 sine cosine. Sine cosine, it comes from double angle formula. Sine cosine, it's from what? From double angle formula. 12 sine cosine, so it is from sine 2, okay, sine 2x. So how can we do this? Sine cosine, sine squared, cosine squared. Do you have any idea about this? Okay, we can remember, just remember sine 2x, it's 2 sine x cosine x. If we're squaring both sides, so when we square this side, so also we have to square the left side. So by squaring this, we will get sine squared 2x equals 4 sine squared x cosine squared x. But here we have 12. We can write 12 as 3 times 4. 3 times 4 equals 12. Sine squared x, cosine squared x. Is it show that? Then we start with the left hand side. Okay? 4 sine squared, cosine squared, it's a sine double angle. Sine squared 2x. Then it will be 3 sine squared 2x. What about sine 2x? sine 2x or sine squared comes from double angle formula. Cosine 2x equals 1 minus 2 sine squared x. Rearrange it. So 2 sine squared x equals 1 minus cosine 2x. Just I rearrange it. Now, what do we need? We need sine squared without 2. Then we divide by 2. So sine squared x, we divide the right side by 2. It's half. 1 minus cosine 2x. Also, we need double angle. Then x, this x, we need to double it. So we write x as 2x. Why? Because we need to get this value. Then we double this angle. 2 times 2, it's 4x. Then sine squared 2x equals half 1 minus cosine 4x. Then we replace this bracket by this value. So it is 3 multiplied by half open bracket 1 minus 4 cosine x. 3 times a half, it's 3 over 2. 1 minus 4 cosine x, which is the right hand side. Okay? Any question? Okay? Now, next question. Question number 3. Solve the equation.
Mister,
yes,
I didn't understand. How did we get 3 sine square 2x up?
3 sine squared 2x, yeah.
How did we get it?
Yes, just we look at this here, it is sine cosine. So sine cosine comes from double angle, comes from sine 2x. So sine 2x, it's 2 sine cosine. We're squaring both sides because we need a square. Then sine squared 2x equals 4. You understand this step?
Yes, mister. Okay.
Now, this 12, just we need 4 from it. So 12 is 3 times 4. So just we write 12 as 3 multiplied by 4 sine. All of them product. Then we take 4 sine squared cosine squared all together and replace them by its value, which is sine squared 2x. 3 is outside, and then we continue. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Now, try to solve the question number 3. Solve the equation. Ready? Let us we do. First of all, we expand both sides. The left side is sine x cosine 30 sine cosine plus cosine x sine 30 equals. Right hand side, it's 2. Cosine x plus 60, it's cosine. Cosine minus sine 5. We find the value of cosine 30 by using the calculator. So we find this value, okay, also this value, this value. Okay, now, cosine 30, by using the calculator, it's radical 3 over 2. Sine 30, it's half. Cosine 60, it's half. Sine 60 is radical 3 over 2. Now, be right here. Square root of 3 over 2 sine x plus half cosine x equals. When you distribute 2, 2 times half equals 1. So it's 1 cosine x. 2 multiply radical 3 over 2, it's radical 3 sine x. Okay? If I said solve the equation, we must convert the equation to just one function. Here we have two functions, sine and cosine. But we know that sine over cosine is 10. Then we divide each term by cosine x to convert all to one function. So divide this by cosine x, sine over cosine 10. Divide this term by cosine x will be 1. Divide by cosine x. Divide by cosine x. So each term, okay, can we use our formula? No. 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 Okay? No. This is better way. Okay? Try to solve. If you get the answer, it's okay. But I think not possible here. Okay, here. Sine divided by cosine, it's 10. So it's radical 3 over 2, 10x. Cosine over cosine, it's 1. 1 times half is half. Cosine divided by cosine 1, radical 3, sine over cosine, 10x. Collect 10. X in one side. Then what we do here, we shift 10 to this side and the half to the other side. Okay. Just I use the record just 1 minute because I have to do something please here. Use record. Okay, guys. Now we collect 10 together. So radical 3 over 2, 10x plus radical 3, 10x equals 1. When we shift half to the other side, it will be minus half. We take 10x common factor. Then it becomes radical 3 over 2 plus radical 3. 1 minus half is half. Now use your calculator to get the answer of radical 3 over 2 plus radical 3. Use your calculator, please, to get the answer. Radical 3 over 2 plus radical 3. It's okay, equals 3 radical 3 over 2. Again, so fraction radical 3 over 2 plus what is that sound? Sorry, who is that sound, please? Who makes that this sound? This sound, please, from Muhammad? Muhammad Nasser?
Hello, Mr. It's not me.
Who is that? Who makes that sound? Sorry. Sorry, no problem. No problem. Now, it is 3 radical 3 over 2. So, 2, no, sorry, 3. Radical 3 over 2, 10x equals half. To get 10x, we divide by 3 radical 3 or multiply by 2 to be easier. So multiply both sides by 2 to cancel half. Then 3 radical 3, 10x equals 1. I complete in this side. So tan x equals 1 over 3 radical 3. Now, this value is positive. When tan is positive, if you remember, tan is positive if the angle in the first or in the third. So the angle x lies in the first quadrant or in the third quadrant. But take care. The domain here, it's from negative 180 to positive 180. Okay, guys. If the domain from negative 180 to 180, we minus 360. We minus 360. Let us continue. We said the angle in the first or in the third. Okay, I complete down here. Now, this is the first quadrant, and this is the third quadrant. We find the angle in the first quadrant. Shift tan 1 over 3 radical 3. Now, shift tan fraction 1 over 3 radical 3 equals, what is your answer? 10.89 degrees. This is acceptable. Okay, because it is in the domain from negative 180 to 180. Then we take this value. In the third quadrant, we write x equals 180 plus 10.9. It is refused. But we write the answer. It's 1 plus 180. So the answer is 190.9. 190.9 degrees, this is refused. Okay? Because it is more than 180. Now we minus 360 from both. So we say minus 360, 10.9 minus 360. This is all. Why we minus 360? Because the domain from negative 100 to positive 100. So 10. equals negative 349.1. So this is sorry for that sound. Who is that sound? Who makes that sound? Okay. Yeah, so this is refused. Now, on the other side here, we minus 360. So 190.9, why we minus 360? It is complete revolution. Do not subtract 180 wrong. So 190.9 minus 360, it is negative 169.1. So x equals negative 169.1 degrees acceptable. Why we're doing the last step, we minus 360? Because they said the domain x from negative 180 to positive 180. Then the final solution is that. So the solution is 10.9 degrees or negative 169.1 degrees. Okay, guys. Next, try to solve this. Try to solve that question, please. Ready? Of course, if it said show that, we have to start from one side. We start with the left-hand side. I help you. Left hand side equals. Look, please. Cosine 2x, cosine x. We can convert cosine 2x to cosine by double angle formula. Cosine 2x equals 2 cosine squared x minus 1. Then we replace cosine 2x by 2 cosine squared x minus 1. right? 2 cosine squared x minus 1 plus 9 cosine x plus 5 over cosine x plus 4. Rearrange the numerator. 9 cosine squared x plus 9 cosine x, okay, 9 cosine x okay guys. Now negative 1 plus 5, it's 4. Negative 1 plus 5, it's plus 4 over cosine x plus 4. We need to factorize the numerator. Follow me, please. This step is important. So we need to factorize this. How to factorize, okay, this one? Okay, I will tell you. Okay, so by using the calculator, factorize. How can we use the calculator to factorize? Now, go to mod 3, 3. 9 equal 9 equal 4 equal. Oh, no, no. I think here 5, I just here 2. Oh, this is 2, not 9. I write 2 in mistakes here. Sorry. Sorry. This is not 9. It is just 2. Okay. Sorry for that mistake. It's a 2 here, the first one, 2 cosine squared. Now, by using the calculator, mod 3, 3, 2. Equal 9 equal 4 equal equal. You will get x equals what here? X equals the negative half. Yes, question? Yes? Yeah. Now, by using a calculator, we will find this x equals the negative half. When you convert to two bracket, multiply by two and shift one to the other side, it becomes 2x plus 1. Press equal again, it's x equals negative 4. Shift negative 4 to the other side becomes x plus 4. Then the factorization by using the calculator, because the calculator solved equation, not factorized. Then it becomes what here? 2x plus 1 in bracket multiply x plus 4. This is the quadratic factorization of numerator over, oh, this is x, it's cosine. So it's a cosine here, not x, x in the calculator. Then it is here cosine 2 cosine x plus 1 multiply cosine x plus 4 over cosine x plus 4. We can cancel the bracket with bracket because it's a product. Then the answer be 2 cosine x plus 1, which is the right-hand side. Now, in that question, we learn how to use the calculator to factorize the quadratic formula. Okay, now, next question, right, to solve that. Take your time for solving it. Prove that 1 minus cosine over 1 plus cosine equals, right? And I help you. Okay. Okay. Now, of course, we start with the left-hand side. Left-hand side equals. Look, 1 minus cosine 2x. We need to cancel this one. Now we return back to cosine 2x. Cosine 2x equals 2 cosine squared x minus 1 or equals 1 minus 2 sine squared x. Which formula we use it in the numerator? Because here we have negative. If we use 2 cosine squared minus 1 becomes a plus 1, so cannot be cancelled. Then it's better to use the second one. Then we replace cosine 2x by 1 minus 2 sine squared x. Then we complete. So here we have 1 minus in front this one. Now, in the denominator, it's a cosine 2x. We need to cancel 1, so we use the first one. So we replace it by 2 cosine squared x minus 1. Then this is a bracket here, and this plus 1. Complete. When you expand the bracket, it becomes 1 minus 1. Negative times the positive, it's positive. Negative times the negative, it's positive. 2 sine squared x over 1 plus 2 cosine squared x minus 1. Simplify. 1 cancel with negative 1. And that, what do we know? We want 1 cancel with negative 1. Then it will be 2 sine squared x over 2 cosine squared x. We cancel 2 with 2. So cancel this 2. Sine over cosine is 10. So sine squared over cosine squared is 10 squared x. Here it said theta. No problem. We can change x to theta for all. So it becomes theta. This is theta because it is given. Theta. And this is theta because the identity is true for any theta or x. Okay. So it is what here? It is right hand side. Okay. Let us do the next one. Start please to solve, and I give you time to solve the equation. Okay. Here, the domain is from 0 degree to 180 degree. We have to convert the tan x to double angle or double angle to tan. Of course, it's easier to convert the tan 2x to x by using a double angle formula. Tan 2x equals 2 tan x over 1 minus tan squared x. Then we replace tan 2x by 2 tan x over 1 minus tan squared. So is it solved? It is not identity. Then we write here tan x multiply tan 2x, it's 2 tan x over 1 minus tan squared x. Already equals 1. Simplify. This is in the numerator, so we multiply it together. Tan x times 2 tan x, it's 2 tan squared x over 1 minus tan squared x equals 1. We can write 1 as 1 over 1. Then we do cross multiplication. Scissors, 1 times 2 tan x, 2 tan squared, it's 2 tan squared x equals 1 minus tan squared x. Collect tan squared together to be a subject. 2 tan squared plus 1, 3 tan squared. Then 3 tan squared x equals 1. Divide by 3, then tan squared x equals 1 over 3. Do you know the equation? If we have x squared equals a, so x equal, you remember, positive or negative square root of a, because it's a tan squared, then we write here tan x equal positive or negative square root of 1 over. Then we have here two solutions. Tan x equals radical 1 over 3 or tan x equals negative 1 over radical 1 over. Tan x equals 1 over radical 1 over 3, it's positive. Then the angle tan is positive in the first or in the third part. But he said between 0 and 180. Then it is in the first or second. Then we refuse the third. So it is just in the first quadrant. So this is refused. Why? Because the domain from 0 to 180. Now we find the value of x by the calculator. Shift tan square root. Do this, please. Mod 1. Shift tan fraction 1 over 3 equal. It is exactly 30. This is acceptable. It is in the domain. Now, on the other side, tan x equals negative 1 over radical 3. Tan x is negative if the angle in the second or fourth. So x in the second or fourth. The same way, it is refused in fourth because it's from 0 to 180. So we reject the fourth. We find it in the second. But we find its value in the first without the negative. It will be 30. Then in the second, it becomes 180 minus 30. 180 minus 30, it's 50. So x equals 150 degrees. So this is the solution. Okay, guys? Now, next question. Start to solve, and I help you, of course. But start. Okay, solve. Okay, yes, question. Okay. Yes, Omar. Okay, ready? Okay, start, solve that equation. Solve it from 0 to 270 in that one, okay? Now, how can we solve this? Tan 2x plus tan 50 over 1 minus, it is tan sum of two angles. So that are the two angles, the 2x and 50. So the first angle is 2x and the second angle is 50. Then it's a tan A plus B. A is 2x and B is 50. Then the left side direct is tan bracket 2x plus 50 equals 2. We need to solve this. Now it's easy. Tan 2x plus 50 equals 2. 2 is positive. When tan is positive, so the angle lies in what? The angle in what? Tan is positive in first or third quadrant. Now we divide the paper into two halves. So the angle may be in the first or in the third quadrant. Now, follow me. If you find the 2x, you have to add 360. 2x here, can you see? This is 2x. When you see 2x, you have to add 360 to each answer. Like this. In the first quadrant, so we write 2x plus 50 equals arc tan 2. Now we find arc tan 2 in degree, of course. Shift tan 2. So the answer is 63.4. Follow me now. So 2x plus 50 equals 63.4 degrees in the first quadrant. Or 2x plus 50 in the third, it's 180 plus. I think it's 3.4. Now, before to find the value of x, add 360. Okay, try to learn it this way. Then we go down and we write the same 2x plus 50 equals 63.4 plus 360. Why? Because it's a 2x. Also the other side here. 2x plus 50 equals 180 plus 63.4 plus 360. So it's plus 360. We find the value of x in each equation. So in that one, how can we get x? Follow me, please. Write with me. 63.4 minus 50, press equal, divided by 2, press equal. So the answer is, okay, 6.7. Acceptable. So this answer is in our domain. The domain is set from 0 to 270. Now, in this side, follow me, please. Write with me. 180 plus 63.4 minus 50, press equal, divide by 2, equal. It is 96.7, also acceptable. So this answer is acceptable. Now, doubt. Follow me, please. You can use your calculator with me. 63.4 plus 360 minus 50 from other side, press equal, and then divide by 2. Press equal again. The answer is 186.7. 186.7 degrees. Also, this answer acceptable because it's less than 270 in this side. Follow me. 180 plus 63.4 plus 360 minus 50, press equal, divided by 2, equal. It's 276.7. It is refused. Why? Because it is outside the domain. Then the solution of this question is that 6.7, 96.7, or 186.7. Now, solve the next question, please. Okay. Number 8. I give you time to solve. Try. What is the difference between this question and the previous one? Here we have by. If you find by, you have to convert the system to radian. So convert to radian. Okay, so now shift mode 4. You find R in your calculator. Now start to solve this. 2 cosine 2 theta sine. Here we have cosine and the sine. We have to convert one of them to the other. Of course, we can transfer cosine 2 theta to sine 2 theta. How? By using this. Cosine 2 theta equals 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. Okay, now start, please. Ready? So we write here the left side here. 2 cosine 2 theta replaced by 1 minus 2 sine squared theta equals 5 minus 13 sine theta. Expand. 2 times 1, it's 2, minus 2 times 2, it's 4. Sine squared theta equals 5 minus 13 sine theta. Rearrange the formula to be quadratic formula, okay? To be quadratic formula, okay? Yeah, how? It's like this, to be like this. A x squared plus b x plus c equals 0. So we shift negative to the other side to be positive. So it's 4 ساين سكوير دي سيتا ماينس 13 ساين ثيتا، وي شيفت 2 تو ذا اذر سايد، ات بيكمز ماينس 2. 5 ماينس 2 ات از 3. So it's plus 3 equals 0. Okay. Can you complete the solution, please? Okay. Complete the solution after this step. Okay. How to complete? We use the factorization. Also, we go to the calculator, mode 3-3. Go, please, with me. Mod 3-3. 4 equal negative 13 equal 3 equal equal. We find here x equal 3. Then it becomes x minus 3. Press equal again. You'll find the x equals a quarter. Multiply by 4 and the shift 1. So it's a 4x minus 1. So this is the factorization. X is sine. Then we write the answer as sine theta minus 3 in bracket. Multiply 4 sine theta minus 1 equals 0. So sine theta equals 3. Okay. Of course, it's refused. Or sine theta equals a quarter. Sine theta, it is in between negative 1 and 1. So this is refused. Sine theta equal quarter, it's a positive. When sine d positive in the first quadrant or in the second quadrant? We find the value of theta by in radian. Okay, now shift sine quarter, 1 over 4. It is 0.25 radian. In the
Yes, sorry. Now my voice is clear because sometimes it's a battery. It's okay? Yeah. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Okay. Okay, now, thank you, Sha. Thank you, thank you. Now, given that 2 cosine equals the sine without using calculator, show that. Try to solve that question, please, without using calculator. Okay. Do you know how to solve it, please? Okay. We expand, of course, both sides. Okay. So we expand. So 2. Ready? Ready, guys? So 2 cosine here, 2 5. We can just take a break 5 minutes and return it back. Okay, guys, we take a break and return it back. It's okay. So I make abuse for prayer time. Okay. Okay, question number 9, they said given that 2 cosine x plus 30 equals sine x minus 30 without using a calculator, show that tan x. Okay, Now, start to what here? Okay, سعود. أنا ما أعرف مين سعود. Okay. طيب, start please to expand both sides. Then 2 cosine 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 x cosine 30 minus, because it's a cosine, sine x sine 30 equals the other side, sine cosine cosine sine, sine cosine minus sine cosine cosine sine. Find the value of each one, okay? So, and when you multiply by 2, you will get this answer in simplest form. So, radical 3 cosine x. Why? Because cosine 30, it's radical 3 over 2, it will be cancelled with 2, minus. Sine 30, it's a half, cancelled with 2, it's 1. So, it's just the sine x. Cosine x, cosine 30, it's radical 3 over 2 sine x minus half cosine x. We divide by cosine to shift all to 10, then divide each term by cosine x. Cosine x, cosine x, cosine x. We continue. Cancel cosine with cosine, so it's radical 3. Sine over cosine, it's a 10. Sine over cosine also, it's a 10. Minus half only, because cosine cancel with cosine. Collect 10 in one side, so shift negative 10 and the negative half. Then it becomes radical 3 plus half, equals the radical 3 over 2, 10x plus 10x. We can take 10x as a common factor. Then it's radical 3 over 2 plus 1 multiply 10x equals radical 3 plus half. We can use the calculator to get the square root of 3 plus half. It's 1 plus 2 radical 3 over 2. 1 plus 2 radical 3 over 2. Divide both sides by this bracket. Radical 3 over 2 plus 1, and also divide by radical 3 over 2 plus 1 to get 10x. Then 10x equals 1 plus 2 radical 3 over 2 divided by open bracket. Fraction, square root of 3 over 2 plus 1, close that bracket equal. You will get the answer, which is negative 4. Plus 3 radical 3. Or we can write 3 radical 3 minus 4. This is the answer. Okay? Yeah. Now, next question. Question number 10. Okay? Also, this is in radian. So, you convert the sine to cosine. Oh, this sine 2x? No. How can we solve this direct? If you change the sine to theta, it will take long time. But we have a very short way. If you divide both sides by cosine 2 theta, because you know that sine over cosine 10, then the left side, sine 2 theta over cosine 2 theta, it is 10 2 theta. Cosine divided by cosine, it's 1. Tan 2 theta equals 1, it's positive. When tan is positive, if the angle in the first or in the third. We go to the calculator, we find in radian, you have to convert radian, shift mode 4. We write shift tan 1. Then 2 theta, it's a quarter pi. Or 2 theta, it is in the third quadrant, so it's pi plus quarter pi. I said before, if you find the 2 theta, you have to add 360. But now we add 2 by to both sides before to find the value of only theta, also here. So we write 2 theta equals a by plus quarter by plus 2 by. Why we add 2 by? Because it's a 2 theta. Now we find the theta. Quarter by divided by 2, it's 1 over 8 by. Acceptable. So this is one solution. From this, write with me, by plus by over 4 plus by over 4, breath equal, it's 5 over 4 by divided by 2, it's a 5 over 8 by, also acceptable. So it's a 5 over 8 by. This value is acceptable. Now here, quarter by or 1 by over 4 plus 2 by, plus equal, it's 9 over 4 by divided by 2. It's 9 over 8 by, also acceptable. 9 over 8 by. So this value also acceptable because it is less than 2 by. This side, by plus by over 4 plus 2 by equal 13 over 4 by divided by 2, 13 over 8 by, also acceptable. It is less than 2 by. 13 over 8 by, also this value is acceptable. Then the solution is all of that. So the solution is 1 over 8 by, 5 over 8 by, 9 over 8 by, finally 13 over 8 by. Okay? Next question. Solve the following equation. Okay. Go ahead, please. Solve the following equation. 1 plus 2 tan squared . How can we do this? It's easy. Just shift 1 to the other side. Then we write here 2 tan squared x plus pi over 6 equals. When you shift 1 to the other side, 7 minus 1 equals 6. Divide both sides by 3. Divide by 2, sorry. Divide by 2. Then 10 squared x plus pi over 6 equals 3. This 10 squared. So 10 only x plus pi over 6 equal positive or negative square root of 3. Then we have two solutions. 10 x plus pi over 6 equals square root of 3, or 10 x plus pi over 6 equals negative square root of 3. Remember the domain, we said from 0 to pi over 3. Now, this positive, then the angle in the first or in the third. We find the value, so x plus pi over 6 equals shift tan radical 3. Shift tan square root of 3. It's 1 over 3 pi. So it's 1 over 3 pi. In the third, x plus pi over 6, pi plus 1 over 3 pi. We go to the other side, negative. So it is in the second or in the fourth. Already we found that shift 10 radical 3, it's 1 over 3 pi. Then in the second, we write x plus pi over 6 equals pi minus 1 over 3 pi. In the fourth, x plus pi over 6 equals 2 pi minus 1 over 3 pi. Then we calculate x. If its value included between 0 and pi over 3, we accept it. If it's out, we don't accept. Now, the first one, pi over 3. Pi over 3 minus pi over 6. It's 1/6 pi. 1/6 pi, it is acceptable. It's okay. So, because it is less than pi over 3. So, the first solution, x equals 1 over 6 pi. This is acceptable. Okay. Now, in the second one, we find the x. From this, calculate with me, pi plus pi over 3 equal minus fraction pi over 6 equal, it is 7 over 6 pi. So x equals 7 over 6 pi refused because it's more than pi over 3. Here, pi minus fraction pi over 3 minus fraction pi over 6 less equal. It's a half pi also refused, okay? Because it is greater than pi over 3. Last one, 2 pi minus pi over 3 minus pi over 6 plus equal, it is 3 over 2 pi also refused. Then the solution only 1 over 6 pi. Now, this type of question is very important. Without using calculator, show that. Yes, question? Yes. Why did you, okay, I can, yes. What is the question? Why did you do all four quadrants? Actually, just because here we have to check all the solutions. It's okay, because it's a positive or negative radical theory. I know it's from the beginning, but to be in safe side, you have to write the full answer to don't lose any mark in the exam, okay? Sometimes he changed the domain. Sometimes set from 0 to 2 pi. If it's set from 0 to 2 pi, we take the four solutions, okay? Yeah, now, question number 12, without using calculator. Find, show that tan 15. And that, guys, in that part, guys, we use the special angles. We have three special angles. What are the special angles? 30, 45, and 60. Why they are called the special angles? Because they have exact value when you find the sine, cosine, or tan. Now, tan and the cotan, they are reciprocal. Cotan 15, 1 over tan. Then we need to find the tan 15. So just we find tan 15. We use two angles from that. Their broad, their sum or difference equals 15. We can say 45 minus 30 or 60 minus 45. Both are correct. I choose 45 minus 30. So it's 10, 45 minus 30. Then we can write this as 10, 45 minus 10, 30 over 1 plus 10, 45, 10, 30. Okay, when you use your calculator, it will be 2 minus radical 3, okay? Or you can find the tan 45 step by step. I advise to do step by step, it's better. Okay, yeah. Find tan 45 by using a calculator. Tan 45 is 1. Now, okay, you have to convert your calculator to degree. tan 30 equals radical 3 over 3. So it's radical 3 over 3. 1 plus 1 multiply tan 30, it's radical 3 over 3. When you simplify this by using calculator, no problem now, it's 2 minus radical 3. This is tan 15. And tan and cotan 15, so cotan 15 equals 1 over tan 15, equals 1 over 2 minus radical 3. In simplest form, equals 2 plus radical 3. Then the left-hand side equals tan 15, it's 2 minus radical 3. Plus cotan 15, it's 2 plus radical 3. Cancel negative radical 3 with radical 3. 2 plus 2 equals 4, which is the right-hand side. Okay. Okay, type. Now, without using calculator, find the value of sine 22.5. Okay. Okay. Without using calculator, find the value of sine 22.5. Try to think of that question. 22.5. It is half 45. So we write this here, 22.5. It's a half multiply 45. It's a half angle. How can we get the half angle formula? Remember this part. So we know that cosine, okay, 2 theta equals 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. If we replace theta by, if we replace theta by a over 2, half angle. 2 times a over 2, it's a. So cosine a equals 1 minus 2 sine squared, okay, theta over 2. Rearrange the formula. So 2 sine squared theta over 2 equals 1 minus cosine a. Divide by 2, then sine squared theta over 2 equals half bracket 1 minus cosine a. Now, 22.5, it is 45 over 2. Then we write sine squared, okay? 45 over 2. 45 over 2, it is 22.5. Equals half 1 minus cosine 45. Okay? Now, 45 over 2, I said it's a 22.5. So sine squared 22.5 equals. We find this value by using a calculator. Oh, but he said without. Okay. Cosine 45. Cosine 45. It's radical 2 over 2. So it's a half 1 minus radical 2 over 2. You can use this. You can use the calculator in this step. 1 minus the answer. Multiply by half. Sorry. Again. 1 minus. Radical, sorry, 1 minus fraction, radical 2 over 2 equals, multiply 0.5 equals, yeah. So this is the answer of this part. 2 minus radical 2 over 4. This is sine squared. So sine 22.5 equals a square root of this. Square root of 4 is 2. So this is the simplest form. So this is the answer of this step in simplest form. Okay, now, another question without using calculator. Oh, prove that. This is proving. Okay, yeah. Try to solve this, please. Prove that 2 tan over 1 plus tan squared equals. We start with the left hand side. Left hand side, okay? Left hand side equals. We can rewrite the left hand side as 2 tan, okay, theta divided by 1 plus tan squared theta. Now, tan theta is sine over cosine. So it's 2 sine theta over cosine theta divided by 1 plus tan squared is sine squared theta over cosine squared theta. So it's 2 sine theta over cosine theta divided by, we can write 1 as 1 over 1. The common denominator is cosine squared theta scissors. So it's a cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta, which is 1. Then it becomes 2 sine theta over cosine theta divided by 1 over cosine squared theta. Convert the division to multiplication. So it's 2 sine theta over cosine theta multiply cosine squared theta over 1. Cancel 1 of cosine with cosine squared, then it becomes 2 sine theta cosine theta, which is sine 2 theta, which is the left right hand side. Okay? Now. Okay. Yeah. Now let us see the next question. Ready? Next question, please. Simplify. Sine squared over 1 minus cosine. Okay, how to simplify? 1 minus cosine. Okay. Yes. 1 minus cosine. How can we get this? We can change the sine squared to 1 minus cosine squared. So we write sine squared x over 1 minus cosine x equals sine squared 1 minus cosine squared x over 1 minus cosine x. Factorize 1 minus cosine squared, difference of 2 squared. So 1 minus cosine x bracket 1 plus cosine x all over 1 minus cosine x. Cancel 1 minus cosine x with 1 minus cosine x because it is the same and it's a product. So the answer in simplest form is 1 plus cosine x. Next. Okay. Sorry. Now, he said if tan theta equals half and tan alpha, prove that tan 2 theta plus alpha equals 3. Try to solve this question. Okay, now left hand side equals tan 2 theta plus alpha. Yes, question? Yes. Okay, okay. Yeah, this one. Okay. Okay, just I cancel the bracket with bracket. Yes. Okay, thank you. Now, left hand side, tan 2 theta plus alpha. It is sum of two angles. Then it is tan 2 theta plus tan alpha over 1 minus tan 2 theta tan alpha. Now, we have here tan theta. We don't have tan 2 theta. So, okay, on this side, we write tan 2 theta equals 2 tan theta over 1 minus tan squared theta. 2 multiply tan theta is half. 1 minus half squared. Simplify this one. When you simplify this, it becomes a 4 over 3 in simplest form. Then you go to the left side. Tan 2 theta is 4 over 3 plus tan alpha, it's 1 over 3 over 1 minus tan 2 theta, 4 over 3 plus 1 over 3. By using the calculator, you will get the answer equal 3, equal the right hand side. Next, set solve the equation. Okay, sine squared minus, how can we solve this? Sine squared x minus half sine 2x. Then we have to convert double angle to single angle. So sine squared x minus half, open bracket. Sine 2x, it's 2 sine x cosine x equals 0. Now we cancel this 2 with 2. Then sine squared x minus, okay? Okay, sine squared x minus sine x cosine x equals 0. Take sine x a common factor. Sine x, so it's a sine x minus cosine x equals 0. We need to solve this. How? So product of two things equals 0, then sine x equals 0 or sine x minus cosine x equals 0. Sine x equals 0, it is radian. So x equals 0, acceptable. Yes? Question? Yes? Yes, question 17? What is it? Yeah? Yes, ma'am. Question 17? What happened for question 17? Okay, yeah. Okay. Any question? I continue. Now, sine x minus cosine x equals 0, shift to cosine. Yes, question? Yes. Number 16. What do you mean by number 16? This is number 16. What is the question? Okay. Nothing. It's okay. Now, we continue. Yes. Yes, what is the question? What is the question, ma'am? Tell me what is the question. Just to check. I check. Yeah. You need to check or me? Okay. I check with the calculator. I will check. Put this in bracket, please. Divided by this in bracket. It's okay. Now, I check here. Okay. Bracket. Fraction 4 over 3. Plus fraction 1 over 3 divided by 1 minus fraction 4 over 3 multiply fraction 1 over 3 close the bracket equal, it is 3. It is correct. Yes? I check. Yeah, okay, خلاص. Thank you. It's okay, it's correct. Now, we continue number 17. Shift cosine to the other side, then sine x equals the cosine x. Divide both sides by cosine to be one or single function. When you divide by sine, by cosine both sides, so divide by cosine, sine over cosine, it's tan. So tan x equals one. One is positive. Then it is in the first. Or in the third, we find the value of tan x, but it is in radian, shift mode 4. Now, shift tan 1, it's pi over 4. So it's pi over 4. In the third, so x equals pi plus pi over 4. So this is plus pi. Okay, so it is 5 over 4 pi. So the solution is that three solutions because it said from 0 to 2 pi. Then the solution is 0, pi over 4, or 5 over 4 pi. Now, next question number 18. It said show that. Okay, now we start with the left-hand side. Try to do this, please. Expand the bracket. Remember how to expand the bracket power 2. A plus B power 2. It's a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Try to solve number 18. Take 2 minutes to solve. Okay, now the left hand side equals first term squared. So it is sine squared theta over 2 plus first times second times 2 sine theta over 2 cosine theta over 2 plus second term squared cosine squared theta over 2. We know that sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. Sine squared plus cosine squared, this one, sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. Now, 2 sine cosine, it's a double angle. So it is sine double angle. 2 multiply theta over 2. Simplest form, it's 1 plus cancel 2 with 2, so it's 1 plus sine theta, which is the right hand side. Okay, now next question, solve the equation. Okay, solve the equation from 0 to 2 pi cosine 2x, we shift to one angle, of course, we use cosine squared. So cosine 2x, it's 2 cosine squared x minus 1 minus cosine x equals 0. Rearrange 2 cosine squared x minus cosine x minus 1 equals 0. And then you can continue to the solution. The final answer will be x equals 0 or x equals 2 pi. Or x equals 1/3 pi. This is the final answer because it's an easy question. Or x equals 4/3 pi. Next. Okay. Next question. Now we go to the next part here. Okay. Do you need a break? 5 minutes. Okay. Okay, just okay. This part is very important. A sine plus B cosine equals R sine. Okay, R sine, and okay. Right. Okay. Okay, خلاص بقى. So, I check. Okay. Okay. A sine theta plus B cosine theta equals R sine theta plus alpha. A cosine plus B equals R cosine. But here, remember, okay, okay, A cosine plus B sine can be written in any one of that forms. R cosine theta minus alpha, R cosine theta plus alpha, by what? Expand and equating coefficients. Let us we check what is the difference. Okay, let us we check that one, it's okay? Okay, now, if the question is like that, 3 sine theta plus 4 cosine theta. When we start with sine like this, so we have to be R sine. This is one. And in case of sine, if this plus, this will be plus. Now this is direct. Right. When it will be indirect, if the sine not the same, for example, this plus and this minus, then we have to expand the bracket and equate the coefficients. Now I solve the questions if the question is direct or indirect. Let us, we start to solve this question. He said expand, express in the form. Look these answers. Part I. 3 sine theta plus 4 cosine theta equals r sine theta plus alpha. A equals 3, B equals 4. From A and B, we can get R. R equals the square root of A squared plus B squared, square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared. 9 plus 16, 25 square root, it's 5. So R equals 5. Second part, we can get tan alpha. Tan alpha equals arc tan b over a. So arc tan 4 over 3. By using the calculator in degree, because he said this is in degree. So arc tan or shift tan 4 over 3, it is 53.13. So the first part is that 3 sine theta plus 4. Cosine theta equals 5 sine theta plus 53.13. So this is the first part. Hence, solve the equation 3 sine theta equals 4.5 in the interval. Then, in the second part, we write 5 sine theta plus 53.13. equals 4.5. We solve this. So sine theta plus 53.13 equals 4.5 over 5. It's positive. When sine is positive in the first or in the second? Now, in the first quadrant or in the second quadrant? Theta plus 53.13 equals the shift sine or arc sine, this value. It will be 64.16. In the second quadrant, theta plus 53.13 equals 180 minus 64.16. From the first, theta equals 11.03 degree. In the second, theta equals 62.71 degrees. Okay, now, third part is said, find the least value. What is the least and the greatest? Least value, it depends on sine or cosine. Okay, here, he said the least value of 5 sine, okay, theta plus 53.13. The least value of sine is 1. If he said, oh, so the least value is the minimum value. It's negative 1. Because sine or cosine, remember, sine theta or cosine include between negative 1 and positive 1. Also cosine. If he said least value, we take negative 1. If he said greatest value, we take positive 1. So the least value of sine is negative 1. Negative 1 multiply by 5, so the least value is negative 5. Okay, he said, fine, but here, wait, he said least value, this is plus 7 here. So it is not only this, the least value we had is plus 7. So this is plus 7. So negative 5 plus 7, it's 2. The least value is 2, because he said here the value plus 7, so take care. Now, next question. Express in the form sine theta. Okay, the same way, it's direct. So we find A, B, and then we can get everything. Part I, 4 sine theta minus 6 cosine theta equals R sine theta minus alpha. From this we can get, because it starts with sine, sine and negative, negative. So A equals 4, B equals 6, don't write the negative. And we can get R, it is the square root of 4 squared plus 6 squared. Okay, now 4 squared plus 6 squared, it will be 2 radical 13. Also, we can get alpha. Alpha equals the arc tan 6 over 4. It is 56.3. Then 4 sine theta minus 6 cosine theta equals R 2 radical 3 sine theta minus 56.3. This is the first one. Solve the equation. So second part, it is the same way. We write 2 radical 3 sine theta minus 56.3 equals 3. So we can get sine. So sine theta minus 56.3 equals 3 over 2 radical 3. It's a positive. Then it will be in the first or in the second. So theta in the first or in the second, because sine is positive. In the first, we find the theta. Theta will be 80.9. In the second, it will be 211.7. Now, the third part is said, find the greatest possible value. So the greatest was, look at this. Now, take care. Greatest of what? Of 4 sine theta minus 6 cosine theta all squared plus 8. 4 sine theta minus 6 cosine theta, it's here. It's a 2 radical 3. So the greatest value, we write 2 radical 3 squared. So it's a 2 radical 3 squared. Plus what? Plus 8. So the answer will be 60. So this is the greatest value. Next. Express in the form. Now, can you see this? Here, it is not direct. Why? Because it said sine theta minus radical 3 cosine theta equals R sine theta plus alpha. Oh, in that way, we have to expand. Before to expand, you can get R. How? A equals 1, B equals radical 3, R equals radical 1 squared plus radical 3 squared 3, so it's 2. Then it will be 2 sine theta plus alpha, expand. So it's 2 sine theta cosine alpha plus sine cosine cosine theta sine alpha. Expand again. So it's 2 sine theta cosine alpha plus 2 cosine theta sine alpha. Now equating the coefficient. Sine theta minus radical 3 cosine theta. Now, the coefficient of sine here, this is sine. The coefficient of sine here is 1 on the left side. The right side, the coefficient is cosine alpha multiply 2. So we write 1 equals 2 cosine alpha. So it means cosine alpha equals half. It's positive. Now, the other one. Here, the coefficient of cosine is negative radical 3. The coefficient of cosine is 2. Then here we have to write the negative. Negative radical 3 equals 2 sine alpha. It means sine alpha equals negative radical 3. It's negative. When cosine is positive and the sine is negative, so alpha in the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, we can write the angle as 360 minus theta, for example, or negative theta. Now, we find the value of alpha. So alpha equal arc tan B over A, radical 3 over 1, radical 3 over 1 here, it becomes a 60. But our alpha in what? In the third, in the fourth. So it's better to say it's negative 60. Then sine theta minus radical 3 cosine theta equals r, which is 2 sine theta minus 60. Because positive times negative, negative. Also, yes. Or we can say 300. Yes. Yes, mom. Yes, because here, mom, because cosine alpha is positive, and the sine alpha is negative. Look, in the fourth quadrant, cosine is positive and the sine is negative. Look, this cosine here in the fourth quadrant. Then the angle in the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, we write the angle as 360 minus theta or negative theta. In that part, it's better to write minus theta, because if you say 360 plus theta plus, it will be more than 360. So I advise you to write minus theta, minus the angle. The angle is 60, so take it minus. In all questions, we take minus. Now, he said find the minimum value. So the minimum value is what? It's 2 multiply negative 1. So the minimum value here is what here? Negative 2. You understand? So it's negative 2. This is the minimum. Now we go to the important part about the graph. Okay? So this is important part. Do you need to take a break 5 minutes or we continue? Okay, we continue. Now, sine, it's an odd function. You have to memorize this. The period is 360. The range, it's from negative 1 to 1. The domain is R. Okay, now, what about if it's a sine kx? So the period in this case is 2 pi over k. The same as cosine, but the difference, cosine is even. Okay, and the range, it is the same. Tan, it is odd function. The period is 180. But now, if it is tan kx, so the period equals pi over k. Also here, we have asymptote. So the asymptote equals. If they asked us about the domain, so we write x belongs to R, but x not equal to n plus 1 multiply 90. So the asymptote, it means the point that we have to exclude from the domain. Cotan, it is the same. It is odd and the period. And but here the asymptote is different. Sec, you have to remember cotan, sec, and the cosec. It is even function sec, and the period is 360. Also in case of k, we divide 2 by over k. And this is the asymptote. The asymptote gives us the domain. So we write the domain. X belongs to R. And X not equal to n plus 1 multiply 90. Also in case of cosec. You have to memorize this page, please. This is very important page. Now, let us check this question. Okay, ready? He said the diagram. This diagram. Okay, state the domain range of the function. Now, the domain, we exclude the asymptote. So we write the domain is x belongs to R and x not equals by n, where n belongs to integer. The range, the values of y, f of x is greater than or equal to, and f of x is less than or equal to negative 2. This is the point, 2 and the negative 2 here. Because this is 2 sec. 2 sec, it means here we have a vertical stretch 2. Okay? Yes. Ready? Now, next question. Okay, find, state the domain and range. Yes? Can you see this point now is 3? Because here, vertical stretch is 3. It's okay? Now, find the domain. So the domain in that one, x belongs to R, but x not equal. This is from the paper that I explained before. So you have to memorize that piece, okay? Pi over 2, and n belongs to that. And the range here, f of x greater than or equal 3, it is equal. Or f of x less than or equals negative 3. Now, question number 25, but I here reduce this to not pi over 3, pi over 2. He said, that one, he said, sketch. It is not written, sorry. Sketch, okay, the graph. Y equals the sec x. Now, he said from negative pi over 2, you have to remember that sketch. This is negative pi over 2. Yes? Yes, question? Yeah. No, we have a sketching one. Sketching, okay, you have just, please, I give you all the ideas. Okay, try to remember the figure. Okay? Because it came, all of that, by the way, questions from past paper, from grade 12 past paper. So that question came in the exam, sketch or describe. Now here, just to try to know, it's better. The curve here, this is asymptote. This is x, 0, and this is y. Yes, question? Just to know, because sometimes describe. If you know a sketch, you can describe. I advise you. It's up to you. Okay, you can skip it. It's up to you. Here, this is the sketching curve, this one. It's okay. This is one. Just this is the sketching from pi over 2. Yes, it's just to know on. It's okay. Now, describe the graph in terms of transformations. Now, who can describe this? One is vertical translation. You remember? One is vertical translation of scale factor 2. So, vertical translation of a scale factor of a scale 1. It's okay. Of a scale 1. And this 2 is vertical stretch. Okay. So vertical stretch of a scale 2. Now, next, this is the last part here about tan, cotan, sec. Remember that identities. Tan, it is sine over cosine. Cotan, it's a cosine over sine. 1 plus tan squared sec squared. 1 plus cotan squared cosec squared. Now, let us solve identities about this. Ready? Yeah. Now, he said prove that. We go to the left-hand side, left-hand side. Tan, it is sine theta over cosine theta, plus cotan, it's cosine theta over sine theta. Common denominator, okay? Said cross and smile, multiply, okay? Cross, so it's like cross and smile. Cosine times sine, cosine sine. Sine times the sine, it is sine squared theta plus cosine times the cosine, it's a cosine squared theta. Cosine squared plus sine squared 1 over cosine theta sine theta. We know that sine 2 theta equals 2 sine theta cosine theta. If you divide by 2, so sine theta cosine theta equals half sine 2 theta. Then the left side, it's 1 over half sine 2 theta. 1 divided by half equals 2. 2 over sine 2 theta, which is the right hand side. Okay? Now, number 28. Prove that 2 cosec 2 theta tan equals sec. Now, do not scare. Start now. First of all, cosec, it is inverse of sine. Okay, so we can write left hand side equals 2 over sine 2 theta. Multiply. Tan, we can convert to 2 sine cosine. So it is sine theta over cosine theta. Sine 2 theta, 2 sine theta, cosine theta. Multiply sine theta over cosine theta. Simplify. We cancel 2 with 2. We cancel sine with sine. So it's 1 over cosine squared. Look, it's easy. 1 over cosine squared theta equal sec squared theta. This is the required. Hence, solve the equation equals 5. Oh, it means here sec squared theta equals 5. How to solve? Sec theta equal positive or negative square root of 5. So sec theta equals square root of 5 or sec theta equals negative square root of 5. Now we solve this part. Sec inverse of cosine. Then we write cosine theta equals 1 over radical 5. It's a positive. Cosine is positive in the first or fourth. Now, also this sec means cosine theta. Negative 1 over radical 5, negative. It means in the second or third. It is radian. So we find the theta in radian. It will be 1.1. So theta equals 1.1. In the fourth, it is refused because already it is between 0 and the pi. In the second, we acceptable. So it's pi minus 1.1, which is 2.03. In the third, it's refused because it's already from 0 to pi. This is the solution. Now, next, question number 27. Solve the equation sine cosec. How can we solve this? Okay, yeah. So we expand the sine. So it is sine, okay, theta, sine cosine, expand. So it's here. Sine cosine plus cosine sine. All of this multiply cosec, cosec inverse of sine. All of this equals 2. When you distribute 1 over sine, sine cancel with sine. Then cosine 30 plus, okay? Cosine over sine, it's cotan. Cotan theta multiply sine 30 equals 2. Cosine 30, it's radical 3 over 2 plus sine 30, it's a half. Cotan theta equals 2. From this, cotan theta equals 4 minus radical 3. Okay, then tan theta equals, okay, 1 over cotan. It's 1 over 4 minus radical 3. It becomes 4 plus radical 3 over 13. It's positive. Then the angle in the first or in the third. In the first, theta will be 23.8. In the third, it will be theta equals 203.8. Okay, now, next. He said in that one, show that, okay, can be expressed in the form. Now, can you see that one here? Now, okay, cosec, it is inverse of sine. So radical 2 over sine x plus, yes, question, yes, go back, it's okay, yes, yes. Yes, question? Yes, okay, yeah. Now, cosec inverse of sine, cotan, it's a cosine over sine, cosine x over sine x equals radical 3. Multiply by sine x, then radical 2 plus cosine x equals radical 3 sine x. Then we can write this as radical 3 sine x minus cosine x equals radical 2. We can rewrite this as r sine x minus alpha. A equals radical 3, b equals 1, r equals 2, alpha equals 30. Then we write this as, okay, radical 3 sine x minus cosine x equals radical 2, which is equal to 2 sine x minus 30. He said, hence, solve equals radical 3. So to solve this, we write here, okay, radical, this is radical 3. Okay. Now we need to solve this one. So we write here sine x minus 3, minus 30, sorry, equals here, equals radical 2 over 2, which is positive. From this, the angle in the first or in the second. In the first, x becomes 75, and in the second, x equals 165 degrees. I know it's a hard question, but try to solve again. This is a little hard question, okay? Now, question number 31, is it true that? I think it's direct, okay? No problem for this. I can solve it quickly, just to reduce the time. So the left-hand side equals the cosine x over sine x minus tan, it is sine x over cosine x equals 2. Okay, we need to get so that. Now we can take the common denominator. It is sine x, cosine x, cosine times cosine. It's a cosine squared x minus sine squared x. Cosine squared minus sine squared, it's a cosine 2x. Over sine x, cosine x. Sine x, cosine x, it's a half sine x. So down, it's a half sine 2x. And up, it's a cosine 2x. One over half, it's a 2. So it's a 2 cotan 2x. This is the answer. Hence, solve the equation. Now, so part B, we write 5 plus 2 cotan 2 theta minus 15 equals 0. So we can solve this 2 cotan 2 theta minus 30 because we distribute equals negative 5. And then we can solve this equation. So the values here will be theta equals 25.9 or theta equals 4.1 when you solve. Just to give you the idea of the solution. Now, prove this one. Take care for this question. Left-hand side equals cosine 4 theta. We can write it as cosine 2 multiplied 2 theta plus cosine 2 theta over sine 2 theta minus sine 2 multiplied 2 theta. You expand this. Okay. Then it becomes here 2 cosine squared 2 theta minus 1 plus cosine 2 theta over sine 2 theta minus 2 sine 2 theta cosine 2 theta. Take common factor and factorize the numerator. When you factorize the numerator by using the calculator, it becomes here 2 cosine theta, 2 theta minus 1 bracket cosine 2 theta plus 1 over sine 2 theta are the common factor, so it's 1 minus 2 sine 2 cosine 2 theta. Simplify, you will get here negative outside, it's a cosine 2 theta plus 1 over sine 2 theta. When you simplify this, you can get here, this is cosine 2 theta plus 1, so it will come here negative bracket 2 cosine squared theta over 2 sine theta cosine theta. In simplest form, you will get negative cotan theta. It is a tricky question, take care. But this is the idea. Prove the identity here, the same way. Okay, but here we start with the right-hand side. Right-hand side equals, we add them, so it's 1 minus sine theta, bracket, 1 plus sine theta. Okay, so 1 plus sine theta, do cross and smile, minus, open bracket, 1 minus sine theta, simplify, it becomes the 2 sine theta over 1 minus sine squared theta. So it's a 2 sine theta over cosine squared theta. So it's a 2 sine theta. We can write cosine squared as cosine theta multiply cosine theta, sine over cosine 10 and 1 over cosine sec. So it becomes a 2 tan theta sec theta. Now, next question. He said, given that cotan. So we can write tan A, we flip it, it's a 4, and tan A minus B equals 1 over 8. So tan A minus B equals the tan A, okay, minus tan B over 1 plus tan A, tan B. Do cross multiplication, okay? When you do cross multiplication, you find that 1 plus tan A tan B, okay, equals 8 multiplied. So you will get here when you substitute tan A equals 4. Okay, so from this you can get here tan B direct by substitution. So tan B will be equal to 31 over 12. Okay, question number 35, I can give you the homework. Here, this one, cotan 90 minus theta is tan theta. So this is the left-hand side, equals. Okay, step by step. Cotan 90 minus theta equals the tan. So it's a 2 tan squared theta minus 6 plus 6 sec squared theta over negative 2 plus 2 cosec squared theta equals, take negative 6 as a common factor, so it's a 2 tan squared theta minus 6 open bracket 1 minus sec squared theta. You can take 2 here as a common factor, so it's a negative 1 plus cosec squared theta. By using the identities, the given, it's a 2 tan squared theta, okay, minus 6 bracket negative tan squared theta all over 2 cotan squared theta. Simplify more. So it becomes radical 8 tan squared theta over 2 cotan squared theta. Cotan enters of tan, 8 over 2 equals 4, so it becomes 4 tan to the power 4 theta. Square root of 4 is positive or negative 2 tan squared theta. Okay, the value of this one here, he said find the value. Okay, but that is the same idea. So you will get here tan A, tan B, tan A, tan B. The answer is negative 2. Okay, now simplify. So we write here square root of 9 sec squared theta minus 9 tan squared theta. We can take square root 9 as a common factor. Sec squared theta minus tan squared theta, which is 1. So it is square root of 9 times 1. It's 3. Okay. Proof it is the same idea. We can start with the left hand side. 1 over sine 2 theta plus cotan. It is cosine 2 theta over sine 2 theta. And then you will get the answer. Okay. Now, the multiple choice, I give you the answer. If you have any doubt, just send me in WhatsApp. The answer of this one here, this is the answer. Already you have the PDF file. Try to solve and then check your answer. Here, this is the answer. Okay, so this is the answer of this. Okay, the answer here. Because the multiple choice is important for you, and also try to make more practice about the multiple choice. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Number six, the period here is pi over 2. Okay, now sine, cosine. Okay, yeah, it is. Okay, yeah. Cosine this one here. Yeah. Now, 9 here, period of this one, period of 6 here, it is pi, and here, sec minus 10, sec minus 10 here, okay, yeah, okay, Muhammad, just give me time, I will send you, of course, yeah. Number 11, sine 2 theta. Yeah, it is, this is the answer. Okay, number cosine a sine squared. Yeah, so this is the answer. Okay. So this is the answer. And then this is the answer. Yeah, this is the answer. Okay. This is the answer. Okay, yeah, this is the answer. A lot of multiple choice questions. Try to practice more and more because they are very important. We covered all the ideas of trigonometry in that lesson. Cosec, it's negative, yeah, yeah. This one is 100. Okay. In that one, this is transformations. Take care, it's an important topic. This is the answer. Okay. Oh, this one is 2.5. Okay, here. No, this is pi over 50. Okay, here, this is the graph. Okay. Just I give you the answer to do the practice. And again, I repeat, if you have any problem, just send me a message and I will help you, because we take more than 2 hours in that lesson. This is the answer. Okay. This is the answer.
أستاذ كيف
Yes.
حلينا سؤال قبل هذا من y
Yes,
greater
I said to you, but just because we take more than 2 hours.
you can
I
explain
will
at
send
least
you
one.
more explanation, yes, in the WhatsApp, or you can send me, it's okay? Just because a lot of time, okay?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, no, just this is the reason. But try to solve alone, and then I help you when you don't know the answer. Of
Can
course,
I ask you
I will
questions in
send you.
WhatsApp, like when I'm
Yes,
revising? Okay.
I will send you more details about this. It's okay? Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Because some questions in the multiple choice need a long way for solving. Okay, sine 2 theta.
Okay.
Okay. To understand, we have to get the answer in details. Okay, guys, in this lesson, we covered all. Yes, you can send me the worksheet. It's okay. Yeah, of course. Now, I try to upload this lesson in YouTube channel. Okay, I hope you understand this lesson. Okay, yes, any other question? It's okay. No, no, not email, just in, okay? Okay, guys, so just contact me in WhatsApp. Okay, see you, please. Okay, thank you.
Mr. Can you
Salam.
send me the PDF? Like answer,
Inshallah, I will.
one answer, one like so I can answer alone.
Inshallah, inshallah, I will
Okay,
send.
thank you, Mr.
Okay, welcome, welcome.
Okay, bye, Mr.
Bye bye.